guess who's back?
Hey guys, this is Gus G, and you're watching Guitar Gear Guy. Thank you for tuning in.
How are you? This is yours truly, Triple G, coming at you for the first time in almost 2 months. It's been almost 2 months since my very last video, which was the NAMM 2019 recap. And, you know, the day job kind of sucks. So, be that as it may, today's Friday. I had a couple of minutes to cut a new video for you guys. And today, I'm showing you Grover Jackson, GJ2. Randy Rhoads Concorde. If this is your first time visiting my video and the channel, welcome. Thank you for your time. There are plenty of other YouTubers putting out great quality content, and you have chosen to spend a few minutes of your valuable time watching this video. I appreciate it. Thank you very much. If you're one of the subscribers that's been with me, thank you again, and I appreciate it. All right, so with that out of the way, let's go ahead and start talking about this guitar. So let me show you real quick what the guitar looks like. So that's the headstock, Grover Jackson 2, hip shot locking machine head, rosewood fretboard, and the inlay markers resemble the actual offset V-shaped body, the neck binding, there you go, and unlike the actual Jackson guitar, Randy Rhoads signature, which would have a little bit more straight lines and then much more acute angle right around here. This has a very swooping curvature here at the bottom, which is very unique. And let's see, this one is equipped with the Floyd Rhoads 1000. They have another version with the string through the body without the floating tremolo. I actually blocked mine. So that's that. Volume, tone, and three-way toggle, just really simple. And on the back side, so on the side, there is very beveled. Is that even a proper expression? Very beveled. Anyhow, the multiple angle bevel, the back, the cavity covers are not recessed. They're sitting right on top of the surface of the body. And the heel joint have a lots of cut right there that you can see, so that you know upper fret access is very easy. All right, what else? And then this particular one that I have is a little bit special in a sense that focus. I have Grover Jackson's autograph on the back of the headstock. So there you go. Anything that I missed so far? All right, so they have this black color one, and they also have off creamy white kind. So there are basically four different variations, two different colors and two different bridge options. Okay, so with that said, you know, this guitar, Grover Jackson, obviously famous making the original Concorde for Randy back in the day, which the original Concorde, if you ever see, I don't know if you notice, but the body actually comes up all the way up to the 15th fret, which I always wondered how does Randy get around there, but hey. So, you know, as far as Randy's concerned, you know, obviously very unfortunate that he left us so early when he was in early 20s or mid 20s or whatever. If you ask me who my very favorite guitar player is ever, that would, my answer would be always Randy Rhoads. It would be not Eddie Van Halen, not even Michael Schenker. So, you know, there's not enough body of work when you consider Randy's work because he left us right after two or three albums. You know, who knows how much more output he would have had he not passed away from a very unfortunate accident. Although I've read somewhere like a interview or whatever that Randy was going to leave Ozzy right after that tour where he passed away from. So, you know, who knows? But, you know, the albums and the songs that he left us to enjoy, you know, it just shows all the, you know, brilliance that was Randy Rhoads. So that I like a lot. And, you know, from my collection, I have this guitar that bears Randy Rhoads' name. I also have Jackson Phil demo signature, the polka dot, which is obviously inspired by Randy's Kurt Sandoval custom V, and I also own the ESP Edwards single cut Les Paul, the ivory creamy white single cut guitar that bears his name, which was also inspired by Randy Rhoads. I don't actually own currently any official Randy Rhoads signature guitar, although this is pretty damn close, right? So this offset V, very popular, you know, after Randy made it very popular. So Randy has, Randy enjoyed a lot of offset Vs. Then there was like Alexi Laiho and even Ola's Solar guitars now have a V model that is an offset V like this. So you would find these a lot. And I think it's, you know, they look sharp compared to, you know, regular V that's even on both sides. You do lose a little bit of a body mass, right? So maybe the resonance difference is there, I don't know. This model here, you got three-piece neck, rosewood fingerboard, and basswood body, and so it's not very heavy. It's very comfortable. The neck shape is a little bit thicker than I would have liked myself, but you know, it's the little things that count. This is not a USA made guitar, even though it's designed in the USA by Grover Jackson. It's got, appointments are great. You got the Hipshot tuners, you got a Floyd 1000, the knobs, potentiometers feel great, and action is just a tad high right now. I did get it used. Action is just a bit high for my own preference, but nothing that is detrimental. if you look at the GJ2 logo there, that is actually not a cheap decal or anything like that. I don't know if it will show. It's like a brushed metal type of finish that is actually 3D. If you there's a texture if you feel the actual headstock there. So that, and you know, the fit and finish is just so great. And the pickups are what they call habanero special. The USA models come with the Grover Jackson round habanero pickups. I don't know if these are the same ones, or since this is an import guitar, maybe they are wound overseas, I don't know. But as the name implies, I'm sure habanero pickups, you know, they're very hot. So the noise could be a little bit unwieldy on a high gain amp. So that's that. And one of the things that I would have to point out to you if you are considering one, by the way, on Reverb, these go for $600 to $700. 600 being the string through and 700 being the floating bridge type of guitar like mine. And if you're considering one of the drawbacks, and I'm being nitpicky here because I don't think it applies to everybody, but let's say if you're not, you know, V's are not made to sit down and play. This to be worn with a strap and for you to rock out on stage. However, if you are not one of those like myself and you're sitting down, the input jack or output jack, however you want to call it, is in a very unfortunate situation here. So what happens is, let's say you use a wireless system like I do, then you plug that in. You can't really straddle that between your thigh, and my camera is not going to show, but because that now gets in the way, you can knock out the little transmitter. If you have a straight up regular cable into the jack, then that also sticks out like that, so you can't straddle between your legs. And then so you do have to use a 90 degree angle cable here if you want to plug it in and straddle the lower horn between your legs and sit down and play. But again, that may not be an issue because you are standing up and you're rocking out on the stage, then who gives a shit about that? So there you go, that's that. And what else have I not shared with you? So yeah, I did play Michael Schenker, who again also is one of my, like, easily my top five favorite guitar players. I played Dr. Doctor at the beginning of this video. You know, just because I have a Randy guitar, you know, playing a Randy lick, a little too predictable, right? Hence why I bought a Kirk Hammett guitar and I played Megadeth riff on that video. So I do stupid shit like that. Anyhow, so there you go. And, you know, it's just overall, this is an import guitar, but just the quality of this instrument you look at, just really well built, just a great guitar, and the price is right. I mean, you're getting a lot of guitar for this, and dare I say, I recommend this over the actual Jackson guitar, Randy signature, whether that's RR5 or even the RR3, maybe RR1 may be better quality than this, I don't know. I don't own one, so I wouldn't know. But I did own an RR3 before, I believe, or was that RR5? I can't remember. But anyhow, so just wanted to come on real quick because it's been a while. So I wanted to share this video with you, share this guitar with you. And hopefully my next video won't take another 2 months because I got a bunch of guitars to show you. And I keep saying that on every video, but it's a damn day job, god damn it. So there you go. And hey, thank you for your time again. Appreciate your time. And by the way, I'm kind of approaching 5,000 subscriber mark. So I think that's when I'm going to do a giveaway of one of the guitars that I own, which would be, you know, 5,000 today's standards on YouTube is really nothing. But to me, it means a tremendous, tremendous honor that so many people have clicked on subscribe. It doesn't mean I get 5,000 views minimum on every video that I put out, but it's a great number, great round, even monumental number. So that's, I'm going to put up something together, which I mentioned on my guitar collection video. I'm going to give away something there to kind of show my gratitude and thank you for you guys continuing to coming back to watch something, you know, what stuff that I put out. Okay, so my recorders are going to go out of battery soon. So let me cut this video right here. So thank you again. Until next time, you guys take care. I've been Triple G. You've been awesome. Peace.